Hi friends, welcome to my channel and welcome to yet another video in the UGC NET Paper 1 series. This particular series is a free initiative taken by me in which I am uploading free video lectures on each of the units of UGC NET Paper 1. I am talking about all the important questions that are expected from each of these units and covering all the topics which are listed in the new syllabus of UGC NET Paper 1. Till now we have prepared 4 video lectures on UGC NET Paper 1 Unit 1 Teaching Aptitude, and if you have the Teaching Aptitude syllabus in front of you, you will be able to checklist all the topics we have covered so far. So you will get to know that we are only left with 2 more topics which we are going to cover in this particular video. If you have not yet subscribed to the channel, I think you should do it, because from the next week onwards we will be uploading videos on the next important module of UGC NET Paper 1, which is research methodology. So make sure you have subscribed to the channel so that you get notified about the same. So without any further delay, let's jump right into the last 2 topics and complete them really quick. So the first topic that we are going to talk about in this video is teaching support systems. Teaching support systems are nothing but teaching aids. These are resources that teachers use in order to make learning more effective and long-lasting. So basically, we have 2 kinds of teaching support systems, traditional and modern. Traditional ones include blackboards, maps, diagrams, charts. So I remember that when I was a kid, my geography teacher used to come with a world map and used to hang that near the blackboard and point out different countries and teach us geography through world map. That was a teaching aid that my teacher used. But now the times have changed. We no longer use traditional teaching tools. We now use modern teaching systems, teaching aids, which include projectors, audio-visual aids, and ebooks. So now if you look at the smart classes which are running everywhere, teachers are generally using audio-visual clips so that the students can interact, engage, and find it more interesting. And similarly, now the time is of Kindle ebooks, so nobody is carrying those bulky books in their bags. They just download the book in their device and read it online. So these are teaching aids that are becoming common these days. This is a very general topic. I think you have observed all these teaching aids in your surrounding, and very simple questions are asked in NET exam. So recently there was a question that why teachers use teaching aid? What is the reason why they're using it? And the correct answer was to make the lesson more engaging and to enhance the engagement of the student. So the student should interact, engage, and should find the lesson interesting so that the learning can happen quickly and for a longer period of time. So that is the main use of teaching aids or teaching support systems. Now we are moving towards the end of this unit, and the last topic that we are going to deal is evaluation system. So what are evaluation system? Basically, there's no point of teaching without knowing whether the student has understood the concept or not. So evaluation system helps us to understand whether teaching has been made effectively, whether the student has learned the information, and do we need to make any changes in the teaching methodology so that the student can become better as a learner and we can become better as teachers. So if you look at evaluation systems, 2 major kinds of evaluation systems are formative and summative. Now what is formative? Now formative evaluation systems are basically known as internal exams. These are basically exams that are conducted during the course of teaching so that the teacher can know if the students are understanding the concept, and based on that, he or she makes the changes to the learning style. For example, if I ask you that, okay, I'm going to talk about this topic and whatever you've understood so far, put that in the comments below. So that is an internal examination that I'm taking. I'm trying to assess whether you are able to understand what I'm trying to say. A very simple example would be of a chef. A chef, when he's preparing food, is going to taste food, okay, just before he is going to make certain other changes in the food. So by tasting the food while he is preparing it, gives him important information what has to be added more into the food. That is formative evaluation, while you are evaluating, while the learning is going on. A very simple example would be the weekly test or chapter test that happens. Now, another kind of evaluation is summative evaluation. Summative evaluation is also known as external examination. Okay, so these are examinations that happen after learning has been imparted. So whenever there's a semester, teacher has taught you, you have understood, and now finally you are going to give the final examination, that is the summative evaluation. Going back to the chef's analogy, a chef, after preparing the food, is going to serve the food in front of the customer. And now the customer is going to give the feedback whether he likes the food, he doesn't like the food. That is external examination or summative examination. So formative and summative are two major examinations. Apart from that, there are some other important examinations that you must understand when you are going through evaluation system. Very recently, there was a question asked in NET exam that what is the need of formative assessment? And from the list of the options, the correct option was that it helps to accelerate the student's learning process. So understand the reason why formative assessment is taking place, so that the student's learning pace can be accelerated, can be speed up, can be increased. Now, apart from formative and summative, another kind of examination is norm referred and criteria referred. Now, what is norm referred? Norm referred are basically exams where you are going to create a norm, or you are going to set a benchmark, and on the basis of that yardstick or benchmark, you are going to evaluate other students' performance. For example, when we say that she has scored 9 CGPA, what does CGPA means? CGPA basically means that where do you stand in comparison to the other students? Okay, so whenever we are giving you a CGPA, that means that we are comparing your performance with the other students' performance, and based on that, we are giving you a ranking or a marks. On the other hand, if we look at criteria-based evaluation, that is basically what we know commonly as percentage. I give you 98%, that means you have scored 98% marks. But if I tell you that your CGPA is 9.8, that means that out of all the students, you are somewhere at 9.8 level. There are 2% students who are better than you, and there are 97% students who have scored lower marks than what you have got. So that is the major difference between norm referred and criteria referred. Apart from that, there's another interesting evaluation system, that is choice-based credit system, which was commonly used in these great universities like IITs, IIMs and DU. So, I would request you to put in the comment section below what you understand by choice-based credit system, and let's see how many of you can get it right. So, with that note, I come to an end to the Unit 1 Teaching Aptitude. I had a lot of fun teaching you guys, and I hope you also had fun learning from this particular video series. I will be coming up with another video series on Unit 2 research methodology, which scares a hell out of from a lot of students. So don't worry, I'm going to simplify it so much that it becomes a cakewalk for you. Subscribe to my channel if you want to get notifications about the upcoming videos. Also, along with that, follow me on the social media platforms, especially Facebook and Instagram. I'm putting up new information in regards to the UGC NET changes, exam timetable, exam syllabus, and exam date. So make sure you get the updated and authentic information from those pages. Apart from that, we are also having a website called arpitakarwa.com, where I'm putting up free material for paper 1, like past year papers, and free guidance, for which you can visit the website or you can call on the number displayed above. If you want any guidance on paper 1, you can WhatsApp us on the number displayed above, and my team would be more than happy to assist you. So with that note, I take your leave. Thank you so much. I had a really fun time teaching you guys. So that's it for this video lecture. We'll meet very soon in the next video lecture. Till the time we meet next, happy learning, keep loving literature, and stay tuned to arpitakarwa.com.